So let's start with a presentation using Transtats to ensure package translation completeness. Let's look at software package localization cycle. Suppose we have an internationalization application, and from that we are going to extract all the strings which are related to translation, and we have to extract everything in the form of translation template, for example, pod file. And then we need to push those pod file into any of the translation platforms available out there. And for translations, there are several translators who will translate those files and make them available in different languages. And then we have to pull those translations back. So while pulling back, we'll be having several files, one for each language. And then we need to merge and compile everything back into our application. So this is one complete cycle. This is one very simple complete cycle of software package localization. And then we have to build everything in build system. Like our package needs to be built in build system, and then it got shipped to different channels. For example, different repositories of YUM and DNF, and different several other repositories as well. So this is very simple software package localization cycle where translations has to be extracted, get them translated, and then merge and compile back. Then we have to build the package and then ship. Let's talk about some of the challenges we face within this cycle. The major challenges we face are three. First is everything translated packaged? Like suppose we have extracted 10 strings from our software and push them to translation platform. Out of 10, we got 9 translated. And then all the translations has been pulled back and merged back well before the package or software package are being built into build system. This is first challenge. Second challenge is, are all strings pushed to translation platform, latest to software repositories? So this challenge we can see, like suppose we have 10 strings in software repositories which has been pushed to translation platform, and now with some changes, 2 extra strings has got added in our certain development cycle or something, which didn't get pushed to translation platform. So we have mismatch there. I mean, at software repository we have 12 strings, but in translation platform we just have 10 strings. So there is out of sync condition which actually was there. This was second challenge. And third challenge is there a way to speed up the process, like that particular process, push and pull back that particular process? Now let's have a closer look to software package localization cycle. And in software package localization cycle, if we see it closely, then for an application to get internationalized, a framework has to be used. The framework, I mean, there are several frameworks out there. The most famous one is GetText, and that framework works on, I mean, that are backed by various IT9 components at operating system level, but at application level, that framework has to be enabled for that application so that it can be localized and converted and enabled for different languages like French, Japanese, Malay to get enabled for those software applications. Now let's look at different file formats which actually needs to get extracted from IT9 framework. So various IT9 framework supports various different file formats. One of them is pod file, PO and MO file, and other file formats are INI, JSON, and properties, DTD. Microsoft supports resource files. Properties, DTD are basically related with Mozilla applications. JSON and INI are related. INI is related with PHP files, and JSON is mostly related with JavaScript-based applications, for example, Angular, React, and those frameworks. There could be other file formats as well, like XML and YML. And those file formats, the translations which we store in those file formats has to be pushed in translation platform. And there are so many translation platforms out there. For example, Damlize, which is GNOME's translation platform. We have Puttle. So Mozilla applications and LibreOffice is on Puttle. We have Transifex, Weblet, and Zenata. There are several other translation platforms as well. So we actually, if we see it very deeply, then we can see that everything is happening, or we can track everything by using any of the SCM, Software Configuration Management Tool, like Git, SVN, Bazaar, Mercurial, or others. And once the cycle is being completed and we have every translation backed in our application, it has to be built and then packaged in any of the formats. So there are so many different formats as well. For example, SRPM, RPM, and Debian formats, PKG, APK, and MSI formats. So now we can see the complexity of different translation file formats and different translation platforms as well. So at every level, at each and every level, there is a sense of diversity. There are several options out there, and people follow each and everything differently. So there is a condition of mix and match, and there is so much of, things are hybrid. They are not on standard format. So coping up with these challenges itself was very complex. So we come up with some of the solution which we are going to discuss here. And we can say that these file formats are being shipped in these channels. We can hook up to those channels using Yum, APT for Debian packages, and Brew, etc. Let's have a look at IET9 frameworks. So in IET9 frameworks, this is next level of complexity. In IET9 frameworks, there are so many different frameworks out there. And we can see that the most famous one and the most oldest one is GetText, which supports POMO, these file formats. And GetText was get implemented in different programming languages. For example, C, Python, .NET. Most of the programming languages do have support for GetText. That has been implemented in those programming languages. And there are several other IET9 frameworks as well. For example, from Microsoft, we have system.globalization library, which handles IET9 framework, and it has resource files. Resource X is for .NET onwards thing. And for Java IET9 libraries, we have DDD and properties. For Rails IET9 API, we have properties file. So there are so many IET9 frameworks for different programming languages, and it differs for application framework as well. Like for C and C++, it should be GetText, and for Django natively supports GetText and Python framework. Python has, Babel is one framework which is entirely written in Python. Now for .NET, ASP and MVC, ASP MVC, we have system.globalization, Spring, there are Java IET9 libraries, but that has been wrapped with IET9 servlet, which is available in Spring. Now in Ruby, Rails IET9 API is supported, but there are several other APIs available as well. So similarly, we have Revel for Golang and several other things. In PHP, we have a lot of different implementations, for different frameworks. Like for Drupal, it has different mechanisms by which it supports its IET9. If we go and see for Moodle, if we go and see for Joomla, they have different implementations, and natively they support file formats would be INI. That is fine, but the mechanism by which they support is different. Implementation is different. And for JavaScript, like Angular or React, natively file formats would be JSON, but implementations may vary. So there are variations at each and every framework, and to one or more programming languages. But at core, they are IT9 frameworks. And IT9 frameworks has to be implemented well at different levels so that we can actually go and see like where what is happening. Now, okay. So we are actually looking at one tool that is Transtats. Now let's see about Transtats support. So at platform levels, we have support for Damlize, Transifex, and Zenata. And IT9 frameworks currently Transtats only support GetText, which is pod, PO, and MO kind of thing. In build systems, Fedora build system is supported, which is cozy. And SRPM and RPM are being, produced from Koji build system, which is then shipped into repositories and can be hooked from Yum and DNF. In version control, Git is only supported. Hence, we have support for Pagure, GitHub, GitLab, Bitbucket, and other platforms. I have a quick demo for Transtats. Let's see how that goes now. So this is the landing page. And here we can see that there are a list of languages which has been configured in Transtats. And in translation platforms, we have Damlize and two instances of Zenata, public and Fedora. Let's go back. In packages, we don't have anything now. We have two jobs. I'll explain what jobs are. In products, we have Fedora, and one release is added. That is Fedora 30. Now let's go back to packages and add one of the package. For adding of the package, we need Fedora authentication. This will redirect, and it will take Fedora authentication. Once authenticated, we can actually go and create packages in Transtats. So now we can navigate. Here you can see that we have logged in into Fedora. Now let's go back to packages and add one package. We are adding Ebert. Ebert is one of the package. And we need upstream URL, that is source repository URL of Ebert, which is github.com/Ebert/Ebert. So it is required just because there are a number of jobs which will utilize this link. We can select one of the translation platforms from available, and we are selecting Fedora Zenata. It is added. Now go back and see how it looks. So this is the entry of Ebert, which is currently added. We can sync to three different places. First is translation platform. Second is upstream repository, which is GitHub in our case. And third is build system, which is Koji. So currently, it is going to translation platform, that is Zenata, and fetching out all the statistics and showing it here. So we have two different project versions which are at Zenata. So we can see statistics for 10 languages for Ebert, which are coming from translation platform. Now we are syncing with the source repository. So what it will do, it will actually clone the Git repo and filter all the PO files. PO files contain all translations. And it will crawl those to those PO files and generate statistics. So this is how job runs. We are running the job. It is currently cloning Ebert. The clone is now completed, and 106 PO files has been filtered out. So in the bottom, we can see that statistics will be calculated out of these PO files, collected PO files. So this is the statistics. And the statistics will be stored in that same page. We'll go to that. This is the job URL, which is just run. And here we can see that on the left-hand side, we have YML, which was pushed. And on the right-hand side, we have output from each of the tasks, which was defined in YML file. So now go back to Ebert, and here on the first row, the statistics are coming from upstream repository. So we have statistics from translation platform and upstream. Now we are going to sync with build system. So this is second job. And what it will do, it will go to build system. It will go and collect the latest build details from build system. Then it will download the SRPM, that is source RPM, from the build system. And then unpack SRPM. It will actually load a spec file, which is the source file to build any package in build system. And it will do all the tasks which are required for getting PO files ready. And once PO files are ready, it will just filter out those PO files and run the task to actually calculate statistics from those PO files. So here you can see that we got SRPM. The tarball has been extracted, and no patch has been found. Then 106 PO files has been filtered out from that SRPM. And at the end, we will be having statistics. So this is how we are getting statistics from build system. Now we have statistics from translation platform, we have statistics from upstream repository, and we have statistics from build system. So we have statistics from all three different levels, like where we have code, where we have translations, and where we are building. So if we combine the whole picture, it will show us like where we are lacking, or is everything fine or not. So this is how output will look like for each and every step, which was defined in YML file. So let's get back to Ebert and look at the statistics. The second row is coming from build system. So we have statistics from all three. And now we are going and see, do we have any differences? We don't have any differences between translation platform and build system, so we are good. So for Ebert, we are good. What has been pushed in translation platform has been built. So there is no out of sync kind of situation at these two places. What we'll do next is we'll check, like, is everything we have in source repository, all the strings from source repository has been pulled to translation platform or not. So this is how release summary is being displayed in Transtats. So we have, these numbers are number of strings, and we can navigate to from Fedora 30 release to that particular stage and come back to the package level. So that is very high level scenario in Transtats. Now we can go and run string change job, which will actually go and see difference between source repository and build system, translation platform. So here we can see that we need to check in the source repository, do we have any branch of Fedora 30 or not? Because what we are doing, we are actually looking for any differences for Fedora 30. So we need to give git branch there, and we are going with master because there were no Fedora 30 branch. So we are selecting the package, we are selecting the release name, and it will run the job. What it will do, it will actually create a new pot file, that is translation template file, from first it will clone the repository, then it will create translation template file, and it will fetch translation template file from translation platform as well, and then match those two pot files. So it is matching, and it got 18 messages as differ. That means for abort, for master branch, 18 messages was not pushed to translation platform. So we got difference there. Now, once we can go and see for job log, we can see these are the logs. So for line number 2, so here actually it shows line by line diff as well. And for one of the translation messages which was added, you can see that it is at line number 2051, that is print verbose information. And if we'll scroll down at line number 205, you can see print verbose information. So you can actually go and see the line by line differences as well. You can see the message difference which was not being pushed to translation platform. I'll stop the presentation here because I have one slide left and I'm running out of time. So this was demo, and it was to conclude, like, first, is everything translated packaged? So we can see through package translation completeness the three pictures from different, I mean, the picture where we have translations from different sources. Second was all string pushed to translation platform are latest or not. For that, we are running change job to detect string change. And third is there a way to speed up any of these processes? So yes, we can speed up using YML jobs. This is how Transtats work. It collects data from different sources, from translation platform, and it collects data from release schedule as well, upstream repository build system, using various jobs. There are two main jobs, predefined and YML, which we have seen. Once we have translation data there, we run analytics, and there are several reports, graphs, and charts generated, which is useful for translators, which is useful for developers, which is useful for quality engineers and project managers as well, translation project managers or general project managers. So this application is available at transtats.fedoraproject.org. Source is available at github/transtats, and docs is available at docs.transtats.org. And feel free to join Fedora Globalization or Transtats channels at IRC. Myself is Sandeep, and I'm open to questions.
Can you do YAML jobs to translate something else than text to ensure this is properly packaged with Transtats? What I have in mind is, for example, SVG.
Jobs are actually going and bringing translations from different sources. So jobs are not which are actually for translation. They are just pulling out data. So, could you please repeat your question? I think this was not the correct answer.
Okay, if I have text inside SVG,
right,
which a developer might want to be translated because this is an asset,
yeah,
can we have this in this process?
So that translation process would depend on translation platform support. So if translation platform is supporting SVG translation, then the answer would be yes. So for Transtats, translation support could not be, currently in Transtats, we don't have support for SVG.
Okay, well, thank you.
Thank you.